Okay, ladies and gentlemen, in solving, simplifying, and proving, think of it as a Lego game and Tetris. Okay, that's our notion here. So, what do I mean? Let's say I ask you to build this figure out of Legos. You could build it using, say, you could build it using small squares, a rectangular value there, and then a square, a long one, and a short piece. But still, you arrive at this figure. Or, say you chose to do it this way. You get a long piece and a short piece, and then short pieces, and then two long pieces, and then small pieces. So you might use a different information, but still, you arrive at that figure. And that's how we would be you doing the proving and simplifying. We may use different identities, but still we arrive at the same answer. This is the type of lesson that is focused on the process rather than the final answer. You might get the correct final answer, but if your process is incorrect, then ladies and gentlemen, the solution is still wrong. This is the type of lesson that is focused on solution rather than the final answer. Okay? And then think of it as a game of Tetris. Let's say this is what we are clearing. Ito yung stage na kini-clear natin. Ito. Yan, diba? Isang piece na lang yung kulang. Kaso yung bumababang piece mo sa Tetris, ganito siya. What will you do? What will you do to be able to still clear that area? What will you do with that piece? Anong gagawin mo?
Tataas po.
Tama. I-rotate mo, di ba? Itataas mo, itatayo mo ganun. Di ba? Oo. Very good, very good. Uy, marunong sila mag-Tetris. Ayan. You will rotate it. And it will look like this. Tama. It will look somehow like this. And this now will be able to fit into this portion. At maki-clear na. So, this is the concept as well in identities. Technically, hindi mo naman binago itong mismong piece, di ba? Pinalitan mo lang yung orientation niya, but you did not change the piece itself. You just moved it to a different orientation. And that's the same with your identities later on. We will be modifying them, but technically, they're just the same identity. Nag-modify lang tayo to be able to fit into what we need, okay? So again, when we are solving and simplifying, look at it as a Lego game, as a Tetris game. Okay? That's what you have to do. Because this is a type of lesson that do not have certain steps. Wala kang susundang steps eh. Hindi siya specific. And then one solution could be different from the other, but they are both correct. I am not limiting you to how I am solving. Say this is how I solved, but you solved it in a different way, but still it's correct. It's fine. As long as you don't break any mathematical rule, then it's okay. Okay? Wala siyang steps. Wala siyang specific steps. Kaya, ang kailangan mo dito, diskarte. Kailangan madiskarte ka when you're solving and simplifying trigonometric expressions. Okay? And then you have to think forward, like when you're playing chess. Kapag ginalaw ko to, ano nang mangyayaring susunod? That's how you must be able to think, ha? And then these are some tips. You express as much as possible into one trigonometric function. But if hindi kakayanin, it's fine. You could use factoring. Say, if it is applicable, then we factor out. And then you remove fraction form by applying LCD. I hope you still remember your LCD, but if not, we will just review that in a while, okay? And then lastly, as we go through this, please take note, hindi siya mahirap, matrabaho lang, okay? Hindi siya mahirap, matrabaho lang, tiwala lang, kaya nyo to. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, let's begin with some examples for simplifying trigonometric expressions. All right, level one muna tayo, level one. We have cosine theta, tangent theta. Listen carefully. This is now our first example. Let me begin by changing our term into in terms of cosine and sine. Cosine and sine are your basic are the most basic functions that you could use. Okay? Look at these as two puzzle pieces, as two Lego pieces. One is cosine and one is tangent. Now, if I would be doing this, I will not change cosine theta anymore. Kasi basic na yan, cosine na yan eh. But for tangent, I think we could still change tangent. And I will look at our quotient identities. Look at it carefully. According to your quotient identities, ang tangent daw is equal to sine theta over cosine theta. Again, ah, tangent is just equal to sine over cosine. Ang tangent daw, parehas lang kung sine over cosine. So, isipin mo, ang tangent, yan yung longer piece. Si sine over cosine, siya yung dalawang piraso ng Lego mo, pero pag pinagsama mo, kasukat lang niya to. Ibig sabihin, I could change cosine, I could change tangent to sine over cosine. Papalitan ko niyan kasi they're one in the same banana. So, cosine times, I changed tangent using your quotient identity. I changed that to sine theta over cosine theta. Again, what we used is your quotient identity. Next, looking at it now, what do you think could we do? In my perspective, I think we could cancel out. Cosine is in the numerator and in the denominator, so I could cancel them out. And the operation is multiplication. We are now left with sine theta. This is obtained by canceling out cosine. And ladies and gentlemen, this is your final answer. Ta-da! Yep, we're done. That's it. That's level 1, simplifying.